Alabama was admitted as the 22nd state of the Union on December 14, 1819. In 2020, we now have nearly 5 million Alabamians. Alabama is the 13th largest state in the U.S. with 52,419 square miles. The heart of Dixie is famous for its sweet tea, its southern hospitality,
yes, ma'am,
and of course, football. But the Cotton State does not have any of the four major U.S. professional sports. But what it does have, and does better than probably any other state, is college football.
In your face, all over the place.
We're online 24/7. 24/7.
Yeah, you should have seen the... Oh, shit, are we live? You are listening to 106.3 WTF Radio Sports Talk. I'm your host, as usual, Pat Mawini. And this is the number one sports talk show in all of Alabama, if you don't count the rest. And today we have huge news coming out of the Sun Belt Conference. A new Division I college football team has joined the Sun Belt, and that team is right out of Limestone County in God's chosen state of Alabama. The Nuclear Elks are led by Coach Constantine, who is himself a Limestone native. He's on record saying his goal is to be the best team in all of Alabama. This fool even went and scheduled Auburn and the Crimson Tide for his first season. I don't know about y'all, but I smell a couple ass whoopings in his near future. But as always, the phone lines are open and ringing off the hook. So let's take our first call. I'm sure you can't wait to talk about these Nuclear Elks. Caller, are you there?
Howdy, Pat. This is Junior from Montgomery. First time, long time.
Hey, Junior. Thanks for calling today. What do you want to talk about?
Well, I just got to say, there ain't no way no nuclear deer going to compete in Alabama football. I mean, I can't even pronounce a single name on their roster. I mean, to add to that point, how the hell is an irradiated deer going to play football anyways? All they got is hooves. It's going to be a massacre down there in Limestone County. Roll Tide.
Hey, thanks for the call, Junior. I do want to point out that they are the Nuclear Elk, not the Nuclear Deer, but thanks for the insight. Next caller.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Am I on the radio right now?
Yeah, you're live right now.
Oh, good. This is Jacob Doug Wells calling from Walker County. Now, I heard you boys just talking about some nonsense about mammals that got radiation sickness. That these deer are supposed to come up into Bryant-Denny Stadium and play football with our boys. Our boys are number one in the nation. And besides, I know deer. In the early 1990s, they were a rare treat here in Alabama. I used to have a brother who hunted deer. He was pretty good, too, till one time he went into the sticks and had himself a pour too many out of the paint can. Fell out of a tree blind. Paralyzed from the neck down. Anyways, I wanted to put my two cents in. And don't you worry to all you PETA fans out there. I looked up in the old Google machine that deer have exploded in population the last decade here in Alabama. So our boys should have license to kill them all. Our quarterback will have his cannon aimed right at the belly of the beasts. I'm telling you, it's going to get ugly this weekend under the lights. Thank you very much for taking my call. I'll just shut up and listen now. Roll Tide.
Well, Jacob, I'm not sure what they got in the water over there in Walker County, but I'm going to pray for you and your immobilized brother. But I think we got time for one more call. What's that? Well, I'm being told we got a bit of a famous person on the line. Joining us now, famous Madden YouTuber and the sellout king, Jeromepkr. Jerome, how you doing?
Pat, am I on? Is this thing... Pat, how are you doing?
I'm doing good, Jerome. Thanks for calling.
Pat, I love this show, but have you heard about this new team called the Nuclear Elks? The only nuclear thing that's going to be happening is the implosion on their own team. Nobody's heard of these kids. They've got a coach that doesn't even have a winning record in high school. All I know is these kids better have another hobby lined up, because after those first few games, they're all going to want to leave. Regardless, though, another easy target. Roll Tide!
Thanks for the call, Jerome. And if you're not watching Jeromepkr on YouTube yet, you must be slow or something. You've been listening to 106.3 WTF Sports Radio, the fastest-growing radio show on the planet. Don't look that up. And I've been your host, Pat Mawini, and I'll be back tomorrow to talk more Alabama sports. Signing off.
This concludes our broadcast day. Good night. And God bless America.
Welcome to the Limestone College Nuclear Elk Dynasty. My name is Constantine the Great, and thank you for joining me for what I hope is the first of many episodes. I'd like to shout out my friends Cal and Alex, who helped me with the intro, and of course Jeromepkr, who not only participated in the intro, but a couple of months ago on Twitter, I DM'd him and he basically told me everything I would need to get started. So shout out to him, and if you haven't subscribed to Jeromepkr on YouTube yet, you won't regret it. So let's talk about the Nuclear Elk. My goal for this series is to win the Sun Belt and eventually join the SEC and become the best team in all of Alabama. I figure it'll be a slow process because not only is the team booty, which you'll see in a little bit, but I am also pretty bad at the game. I haven't played basically since it came out, so you will get to watch the players and me grow over time. So without further ado, let's meet the boys. Starting at quarterback for the Nuclear Elk, number 4, freshman Gabe Jansen. Coming in at 6'1" with a speed of 79 and 84 agility, Gabe is a scrambling prototype who will make more plays with his legs than with his arm. His throw power isn't horrible though at 75, and with 77 accuracy, he could develop into a weapon for us. Running back Ted Spurlock is downright the best player on the team. Our only 80 overall, Ted is looking to have a fantastic junior season. With 83 speed, he's not a burner, but he will put his shoulder down and hit you directly in the mouth. Ted is the undisputed leader of the Nuclear Elk. Wide receiver 1 is sophomore Roman Fields. At 5'9 and 171 pounds, Roman is a sneaky good jumper, but can also make plays in the slot. He has low catching at 65, but he uses his 87 speed to get open. Wide receiver 2 is senior Al Gooden. Al is 6'5 with 83 speed and combines that with solid route running to be a savvy veteran wide receiver for the Elks. Rounding out the wide receivers is senior Abdul Richard. Exactly 6 foot tall, Abdul has spent his career as a backup to this point. He is hoping to use his vast knowledge of the game to explode during his senior season. We're rooting for you, Abdul. And we can't forget the fullback, senior Morgan Francis. What can I say about this guy other than he is an absolute road grader? Morgan is thick AF and looks to set up Spurlock to have a huge year. My personal favorite player on offense is senior tight end Omar Graves. With junior Antonio Merrick breathing down his neck, Omar fights every day for his job. With 74 strength, he's more of a blocker, but uses his 65 catching and above average route running to consistently get open. Locally, he's known more for his keg stands than his touchdowns. The two best offensive linemen on the team are senior left tackle Otis Tolbert and junior right tackle Edward Maynard. Teammates call the cornerstone duo Biggie Smalls, although who is Biggie and who is Smalls isn't really known. Moving to the defensive side of the field, senior left end Andre Salas, aka Salsa, and second-year man RJ Avery make up a pass-rushing duo that hope to meet at the quarterback more than a few times this year. Frank Cummings and Desmond Mack are both Ohio-born sophomores who took a chance at coming down to Limestone County, Alabama to play defensive tackle. Cummings is an absolute unit who uses his 91 strength to plow through opposing guards and stuff the run, while Mack uses his surprising 67 speed to get around linemen and make a break for the quarterback. They are both super competitive and both claim to be the number one defensive tackle on the team. Left outside linebacker Quincy Elliott likes to refer to himself as a pass rushing slash coverage linebacker. And with 81 speed and 71 finesse moves, his description of himself is pretty accurate. Quincy is truly the Swiss Army knife of the Elk defense. Middle linebacker Edgar McKinley has had a rough journey to get to this spot. But after battling injuries in high school and his first two seasons in college, as a junior he looks to have a breakout season. With 81 speed and nearly 70 zone coverage, McKinley is a force at middle linebacker. He's fond of saying, "You can judge a player by his physical skills, but you can't crack open his chest and take a look at his heart." Right outside linebacker Mickey Meyer, aka Mickey Mouse, with his 89 speed is a nightmare off the edge for opposing tackles. While his pass rush technique needs work, he's also able to drop back in coverage and cover tight ends and running backs. Mickey is a high motor guy who is often heard telling his teammates to keep swimming. Moving on to the secondary, senior corner and man coverage specialist Elton Dubinsky prides himself with playing on an island. He's never seen a wide receiver he didn't think he could shut down, and while his ego may be bigger than his talent, he is the best cover guy on the team. Rounding out the cornerbacks are two more seniors, Hakeem Good and Ben Cooper. Hakeem spent his first three seasons as a special teams ace, but now looks to show off his ball hawking ability in his senior season. Ben was a bit of a wide receiver prodigy in high school but couldn't cut it in college, and has since made the move to DB. Both look to claim that second cornerback spot behind Elton. The de facto leader of the defense is free safety Walter Henderson. Walter is one of those coach on the field type of players. His father was a coach and his goal is to one day be a head coach in the NFL. But as of today, he's a 90 speed, ball hawking free safety with a knack for making plays. Walter plays deep center field and claims nothing gets over top of him. Junior Dave McCarty is a free safety by position, but is forced into the strong safety role because of Walter Henderson. But with his 93 agility, 75 strength, and 72 hit power, he fits the strong role very well. Dave, however, would prefer to play free safety, and he lets the coaches know this whenever he gets a chance. Kickers are people too, and sophomore Cornell McCarthy doesn't want you to forget that. Although he gets a lot of guff on the team for being a trust fund kid that was too stupid to go to Yale, he has grown on his teammates over time. His 73 kick power and 71 accuracy aren't anything to write home about, but Cornell takes his craft serious and can often be seen late into the night kicking balls while listening to Offspring. Last but definitely not least is sophomore punter Emmanuel McNair. His 78 overall is good enough for the second highest rating on the team. McNair, who served a 4-game suspension last season for testing positive for marijuana, nevertheless takes punting very seriously. When asked what the most important things in his life to him are, he lists his mother, his savior, and punting moonshots. Expect Emmanuel to kick some absolute piss missiles this season. Just to give you an idea of some of the players who may stand out but were not involved in the montage, we have backup quarterback Otis Pennington, who I believe actually has a stronger arm and is more accurate than Greg Jansen by a little bit. Yeah, he is. He is just incredibly slower. Backup senior running back Ralph Pollard will actually be splitting carries with Ted Spurlock this season. That 90 speed is something I definitely want to take advantage of. The fourth wide receiver on the team, Nick Wilkerson, actually has the highest catch rating on the team, so he should definitely see some time. Backup tight end Antonio Merrick's 81 speed actually makes him a tempting option to start, but we're going to stick with Omar Graves to start the year. Senior right end Barry McTaggart actually backs up both Salsa and RJ Avery, so he should see some time on the field this year. Same goes with Alfonso Townsend, who's the backup linebacker at every position. We actually lack depth at cornerback, and you can tell because we have two free safeties as our fourth and fifth corner. So I realized after I made the montage that I cannot switch Dave McCarty to strong safety until after the first season, so he will be the backup free safety this year. And actually, let's see if we can get him in at corner just to get him some more playing time. All right, so McCarty's now the fourth corner just to get him some more playing time. He'll back up free safety Walter Henderson, and our starting strong safety will be junior Kelly Manning, who actually, with his 89 speed, 67 strength, and I believe his man and zone is not terrible. Yeah, 64 and 69, nice. No. So he's not a bad strong safety, but for his senior year, Dave McCarty will definitely be our starting strong safety. We are currently in the Sun Belt Conference, along with South Alabama. I'm not sure how long we'll be in this conference, probably a couple years because we're going to suck for a while, but eventually we will work our way out of the Sun Belt and into the SEC. Looking at the schedule, I've put number 11 Auburn and number 3 Alabama on the schedule, of course. We're going to get blown out in both games. I figured I'd put a team from my home state. I'm actually a U of M fan, but we're not going to talk about that. Texas Tech and Wyoming, week 5 and 6. I feel like we'll lose both those games, but we'll have a better chance. And then we get into conference play. Georgia State, South Alabama, the bye week, Western Kentucky, ULM, Louisiana, Troy, and we end the year with Arkansas State. Now, obviously, the big games of Auburn and Alabama are going to be huge blowouts. I'd be surprised if they were close. Central Michigan, we'll see. Texas Tech and Wyoming, they'll probably be close losses, unless I'm as terrible as I think I am, and then we may just be 0-5 going into the Georgia State game. Going over the gameplay options, I have it on Heisman, because I figured there's no point in playing on anything else. Injuries and fatigue on, quarter length at 6 minutes, game speed at normal. If you guys know any other options I should use, let me know, or if there's any sliders. I figure we'll just start with Heisman, watch me suck, and go from there. For head coach Constantine, I put his first point into scouting, because I figure we need to get better talent on this team and quick. For defensive coordinator Sidney Adams, I put his first point into Rhodes Close, which is your players get off the blocks quickly to stop the run. Teams are just going to run all over us all year, so I figure we get a head start there. And our offensive coordinator Lance Colbert, I put his one starting point into ball security, because turnovers are going to be a problem. So I downloaded the most recent roster that I could find, and I believe I got up-to-date 2020 rosters. I didn't see anything terrible like halfbacks playing quarterback and defensive tackles playing corner. So basically we're dealing with the up-to-date 2020 rosters. As you can see, Clemson, Ohio State, Bama, and Georgia round out the top four. And let's see if we can find the Limestone College Nuclear Elk.
6.5 hours later.
Getting absolutely no respect, we're currently rated 120 in the nation. Looking at our team needs, we basically need everything. Technically, we have players at positions. I mean, we have only one senior fullback. But yeah, we basically need players at every position going into next year, especially right and left tackle because they're both seniors. All of our corners are seniors. Our wide receivers are upperclassmen. Our roster next year will probably be worse than this year. A lot of our recruits do come from Ohio, Pennsylvania, Florida, and Georgia. I did put a lot of recruits on the board from Alabama trying to get some of that hometown talent. And finally, let's take a look at the recruiting board. I've allocated the points for the first week. I basically went through and added a bunch of people that had any interest in coming to Limestone College. Let's go over some of the more exciting players on the board. Now, I know we have a freshman quarterback that should be here for the next 4 years, but I figured we'd start to look at some quarterback talent anyway. Three-star quarterback John McDonald is actually interested in coming, and so is Garen Jackson. Kind of an exciting halfback prospect is three-star Will Roach. We're pretty far down his board, but I'm going to keep points on for now. The guy I'm the most excited about is four-star receiver Derek Powell. Pretty far down his board at the moment, but he's a guy to keep an eye on. We currently have a lead on three-star tight end David Davis. David Davis. We got to get him. Now, I know we really need tackles, so I'm going to have to add some more tackles to the board. But in the meantime, we have a three-star Kevin Stewart and a two-star Mark Ray. It's rare for us to have a lead, so I figure I'd show you two-star DN Eric Cooper, also out of Alabama. And we're not that far down the board on three-star defensive end Leon Williams. Only one D-tackle on the board right now, and that's two-star Perry Brown. We're going to be in a big battle for one-star JUCO middle linebacker Ray Harris, but I don't want him to go to South Alabama. Good news on the cornerback front, we're actually in the lead for cornerback John McDonald, cornerback Sean Griffin, and David McCollum. We need all three of these guys. A guy that I figure we probably don't have a chance at, but I really like, is four-star free safety Alex Harrison out of Evergreen, Alabama. Maybe a more realistic option, two-star Mark Pennington. And I figure we might as well go after a kicker, so we're looking at three-star kicker Andrew Clancy out of Alabama. The only athlete currently on the board right now, and I know it's probably not going to happen, is five-star CJ Gilliam. Man, that would be sweet. If you guys have any tips or tricks for scouting, please let me know. I'm just getting back into the game, and I would love some advice. And that'll about do it for the first episode of the Limestone College Nuclear Elk Dynasty. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed, hit the like button, subscribe, and leave a comment telling me either what I'm doing wrong or what you would like to see in the future. I made a Twitter specifically for this series, so follow me there for all updates concerning the Nuclear Elk. My name is Constantine, thank you for joining me, and I will see you next time. Later!
I'm too fly. Check the peace, check the rain. Next time you catch me, I might spread wings.
Fly. I roll Han Solo, don't need nobody for help. And when I'm up in this bitch, I'm fly like Millennium Falcon. And bitches know they ain't welcome. All these rappers, I'll get them.